हेलो क्लास 7 स्टूडेंट्स, स्टे एट योर होम, स्टे सेफ। टुडे वी विल डू एरिया ऑफ रेक्टेंगल एंड स्क्वायर। लेट्स वर्क आउट 17 गवर्नमेंट बुक एंड एक्सरसाइज 26 ऑफ केसीना। ओके, सो स्टार्ट। एरिया ऑफ रेक्टेंगल एंड स्क्वायर। At first we are starting, let's work out 17 of government book. To do the sums of area of rectangle and square, we have to know some formulas. What are they? First, formula number 1, area of square. Area of square is equal to what? Side into side square unit. Next, area of rectangle. What? Area of rectangle is length into breadth square unit. Number 3, perimeter of square. Perimeter of square is equal to 4 into side unit. Next, number 4, perimeter of rectangle is equal to 2 into length plus breadth unit. Next, number 5, area of 4 walls. Area of 4 walls is equal to 2 into length plus breadth into height, or 2 into length plus breadth means we know perimeter. Perimeter, so we can write perimeter into height. So these 5 formulas you have to memorize to do the sums of these chapters. Okay, now I am starting. 2 part 4. 2 part 4. 1 square kilometer is equal to box square decameter. Kilometer, then hectometer, then decameter. 1 kilometer is equal to 100 decameter, but 1 square kilometer is equal to 100 into 100 decameter. That means 1, then 0, 0, 0, 0 square decameter. 5, part 5. 1 square meter is equal to box square hectometer. Okay, hectometer, then decameter, then meter. Okay, so 1 square meter is equal to 1 by 100 hectometer. 1 meter is equal to 1 by 100 hectometer, but 1 square meter is equal to 1 by 100 into 1 by 100 square hectometer. That means 0.0001 square hectometer. Understood? 1 by 100 into 1 by 100, that is 0.0001 square hectometer. Now I am showing the sums. Sum number 4. The length and breadth of a page of my exercise book is 15 centimeter and 12 centimeter. This is the page of my exercise book. Length is 15 centimeter, breadth is 12 cm. Respectively, a margin of width 2 cm is drawn on all sides. Margin 2 cm on all sides I have drawn. This is 2 cm, this space is 2 cm, this space 2 cm, this space 2 cm. Clear? And wrote inside the margin. Inside the margin I wrote. Let's also draw a rough sketch for the problem. Find the area of the portion on which I wrote. Let's also find the area of the portion on which I have not written. So, at first, I find the area of the page. The area of the length of the page is 15 cm, breadth is 12 cm. So, area of the page is equal to 15 into 12 square centimeter. 15 2s are 30, carry 3, 15 1s are 15, 3, 18. 180 square centimeter. Okay. Now, here in this space I have written. So, what is the length? Length is 2 cm less from this side, 2 cm less from this side. So, length of the space where I wrote is equal to 15 minus 2 minus 2. 15 minus 2 minus 2 centimeter. That is 15 minus 4 centimeter. That is 11 centimeter. Similarly, breadth of the space where I wrote, this one 12, this one 12 minus 2 minus 2. 12 minus 2 minus 2 centimeter. That is 12 minus 4 centimeter is equal to 8 centimeter. So, the area of the space I wrote, that is 11 into 8 square centimeter. Therefore, area of the space I wrote is equal to 11 into 8 square centimeter is equal to 88 square centimeter. This is the answer number 1. First answer, area of the portion on which I wrote. Next, also find the area of the portion on which I have not written. Number 2, question number 2. So, total area is 180 square centimeter we have found. And area of the portion on which I wrote 88 square centimeter. So, area of the portion where I have not written, this one minus this one. Therefore, area of the space where I have not written is equal to 180 minus 88 square centimeter. This is the answer number 2. Okay, understood? Next, I am showing sum number 6. Maria's family has a square plot of land of side 20 meter. Square plot of land side 20 meter. This is the plot, square plot. This is 20 meter, this is 20 meter. Length and breadth both are 20 meter. A path 1 meter wide runs all around it from outside. 1 meter wide. A path 1 meter wide all around outside. This is 1 meter. This is 1 meter. All side 1 meter. Let's find the area of the path. We have to find the area of the path. Okay. Now, area of the square plot. Side of the square plot is 20 meter. So, each side of the square plot is equal to 20 meter. Therefore, area of the plot is equal to 20 into 20 square meter, that is 400 square meter. Clear? Now, length of the plot including path, this is 20, this side path 1 meter, this side 1 meter. So, length of the plot including path 20 plus 1 plus 1. Length of the plot including path is equal to 20 plus 1 meter is equal to 22 meter. Similarly, breadth of the plot also same. Breadth of the plot including path also 20 plus 1 meter, that is 22 meter. Therefore, area of the plot including path 22 into 22 square meter, 484 square meter. So, area of the plot, that means this one, is 400. And total area of the plot including path is 484 square meter. So, area of the path is this one minus this one. Therefore, area of the path is equal to 484 minus 400 square meter. That is 84 square meter. This is the answer. Clear? Next, I am showing sum number 8. The length of Koremangala's plot of land twice its breadth and its area is 578 square meter. Find the length, breadth and perimeter of Koremangala's land. Let breadth is equal to x meter and length is twice its breadth. Therefore, length is equal to 2x meter. Therefore, area is equal to 2x into x square meter. That is 2x square meter. But given that area is 578 square meter, therefore according to problem 2x square is equal to 578 or x square is equal to 578 by 2. X is equal to root over 289. Finding square root both sides. Finding square root both sides. Both sides. Now root over 289. (Clears 17 इंटू 17, सो इज इक्वल टू रूट ओवर 17 इंटू 17, दैट इज इक्वल टू 17. सो एक्स इज इक्वल टू 17, दैट मीन्स व्हाट वी हैव टेकन एक्स, ब्रेथ इज इक्वल टू एक्स, सो ब्रेथ इज इक्वल टू 17 मीटर. Therefore, breadth is equal to 17 meter. Now, length is twice of the breadth. So, length is equal to 2 into 17 meter. That is 34 meter. Length, breadth and perimeter. Therefore, perimeter is equal to 2 into length plus breadth. 34 plus 17 meter, 2 into 51 meter, 102 meter. So answer, length, breadth and perimeter. Length is 34 meter, this is first answer. Breadth is 17 meter, this is second answer. And perimeter is 102 meter. This is third answer. Clear? Now I am showing sum number 11. There is a figure. I am drawing the figure. This is a plot. 60 meter. Length is 60 meter. And breadth is 40 meter. Length is 60 meter, breadth is 40 meter. Two 5 meter wide path is dividing a rectangular garden into 4 equal parts. In the middle there is a path. There is a path, two paths, and it has divided into 4 equal parts, and the two paths are 5 meter wide. This is 5 meter, this is 5 meter, both side 5 meter wide. Let us calculate the cost of paving the path at rupees 80 per square meter and also find the area of the each part of the land. At first we have to find out the area of the path. Now see, first we are finding area of this path. Area of this path means this is length and this is breadth. Length is what? 60 meter, this one, and breadth is 5 meter. So area of the path is equal to first 60 into 5 plus, then area of this path, this one means 40 into 5. Now this one we have taken, this one we have taken, but the middle portion we have taken twice. So we have to take one time, but we have taken twice. So one time we have to subtract. That means this portion's area, 5 into 5. 5 length, 5 breadth, square portion. So minus 5 into 5. This is the full area of the path, square meter. So this is 300 plus 200 minus 25 square meter, 500 minus 25 square meter, that is 475 square meter. This is the area of the path. Now also calculate the cost of paving the path at rupees 80 per square meter. And also find the area of the each part of the land. This is the area of the path. Now the cost of paving is rupees 80 per square meter. So total cost of paving rupees 80 into 475. therefore cost of paving the path is equal to rupees 80 into 475 is equal to this zero, then rupees 38,000 is the cost of paving the path. So this is the answer, first answer. Now second answer, also find the area of the each part of land. Part of the land means total area minus the area of the path, total part of the land's area. And now total area of the plot is 60 into 40. Total area of the plot is equal to 60 into 40 square meter, 2400 square meter. Now the area of this plot, four plots together, this one minus 475, therefore area of the four parts of land is equal to what? 2400 minus 475. 2400 minus 475 square meter. This square meter. Therefore, area of each part of land, area of each part of land is equal to this divided by 4, because 4 parts are there, 1925 by 4 square meter. square meter. This is the answer of second question. Okay. Now I am showing some number 13. The cost of cultivation of 30 meter long pieces of land is rupees 150. Had the breadth of the land been 5 meter less, the cost would have been rupees 120. Calculate the breadth of the land. So 30 meter long pieces. So let breadth be x meter. Let breadth is equal to x meter. And length given 30 meter. Length given 30 meter. Therefore area is equal to 30x square meter. If breadth be 5 meter less, if breadth be 5 meter less, then breadth is equal to what? X minus 5 meter. Therefore area is equal to 30 into x minus 5 square meter. Clear? Now in mathematical language, area and cost, area left side area in square meter and cost of cultivation cost of cultivation in rupees. So if the area is 30x square meter, then the cost is rupees 150. If the area is 30 into x minus 5 square meter, then cost is rupees 120. So area decreases, cost also decreases. That means area and cost are directly proportional. Area and cost of cultivation, are directly proportional. Therefore, 30x is to 30 into x minus 5. Therefore, 30x is to 30 into x minus 5 proportional to 150 is to 120. Now, product of extremes is equal to product of means, or 30x into 120 is equal to 30 into x minus 5 into 150. Okay. Now, 0, 0. 30, 30, or 12x is equal to x minus 5 into 15, or 12x is equal to 15x minus 75, or 75 is equal to 15x minus 12x. This comes this side, this goes this side. Or 75 is equal to 3x. Therefore, x is equal to 75 by 3. That is 25. So, calculate the breadth of the land. We have taken x as breadth. Therefore, breadth of the land is 25 meter. This is the answer. Okay. Next, sum number 18. Our local club is square in shape, 15 meter long and 5 meter high. There are 4 doors in the club room, each 1.5 meter wide and 2 meter high. Calculate the cost of oil painting of 4 walls without door at rupees 350 per square meter. So, first, area of 4 walls of the room. Area of 4 walls of the room. I told you the area of 4 walls formula. 2 into length plus breadth into height. Length plus breadth. Square room 15 meter long, 15 meter breadth. So 2 into 15 plus 15. Length plus breadth into height. Height is 5 meter. 5 square meter. 2 into 30 into 5 square meter. 3 2s are 6, 5s are 30, 300 square meter. Okay. Now, 4 doors in the club room. So, area of 4 doors is equal to 4 into 1.5 meter wide into 2 meter height, 2 square meter. 4 to the 8 into 1.5. Square meter. Okay. Now we have to do oil painting, and then we have to do oil painting on the wall, not on the door. So we have to subtract the area of the door from the area of the wall, because this is including the door. Therefore, area of the wall where ऑयल पेंटिंग will be done is equal to 300 minus 12. 300 minus 12 square meter. 288 square meter. Now total cost of oil painting. Total cost rupees 350 per square meter. So 288 into rupees 350. That is rupees. First put this zero, then 288.35 1440. One zero zero eight zero, then another zero. So this is the total cost of oil painting. So this is the answer. Now I am showing Casey Nagbook. All types of sum you have done here. Only two sums are different. In Casey Nagbook, I am showing those. Exercise 26, Casey Nag. Sum number 9. Measure of two adjacent sides of a rectangular field are in the ratio 17:7. Second side measures 3.5 cm. Find the length of the other side. So length by breadth is equal to 17/7. Now second side measures 3.5 cm. That means breadth given or length by 3.5 is equal to 17/7 or length is equal to 17 × 3.5/7 0 5 5 2 are 10 is equal to 8.5. So therefore length is equal to 8.5 cm. This is the first answer. Now perimeter is equal to 2 × length + breadth. 2 × 8.5 + 3.5 cm. 2 × 12, that is 24 cm. This is the second answer. Now sum number 10 of Casey Nag. Perimeter of a rectangle is equal to that of a square with side 18 meter. If the rectangle is 17 meter wide, find its length. Perimeter of the square with side 18 meter is perimeter of the square. You know perimeter of the square 4 × side, 4 × 18 meter, that is given 72 meter perimeter. And perimeter of the rectangle also 72 meter. Perimeter of the rectangle is also 72 meter, and given that 17 meter wide, so therefore 2 × length + 17, because we know 2 × length + breadth is the perimeter of rectangle, is equal to 72. और लेंथ प्लस 17 इज इक्वल टू 72 बाई 2 और लेंथ प्लस 17 इज इक्वल टू 36 देयरफॉर लेंथ इज इक्वल टू 36 माइनस 17 19 देयरफॉर लेंथ इज 19 मीटर दिस इज द आंसर सो थैंक यू वेरी मच स्टूडेंट्स